Hey, everybody. How are we doing? Hey, Max. I think it's behind me there. There you go. You can kind of see it. A doctor plus. Comet is kind of terrified of it. I don't know why. Yeah. Hi, everybody. I am tired, so we'll see how far we go. I kind of want to make my cat a cat again. Comment. Hi.
Yes.
Wallet.
Be careful.
Carefully.
Engine out. Oh, that's cool. Hi, Tuchel. So, Tuchel, do you want to see who we brought home? Hang on. Comet's afraid of it, by the way. Check this out. It is an octopus. And look. There's actually, like, little, like, sucker indents on his tentacles. Come and be like, what the fuck are you doing? He doesn't like the octopus. He does not like our new friend. So. But this is our new friend. Is it a hat? It can be a hat. Not very well. You're gonna post a little gif and then Discord? Sure. But this is our new friend. I saw it in the store and I was like, no way. I've wanted an octopus. Like, I've been wanting my flip octopus. My flip-topuses are good too. My reverse-topuses. But I've been wanting an octopus. Like this, like long suckers, like long tentacles and like everything. It's not perfect, but it'll do until we find the perfect one. It's awesome. I'm checking Discord. I would not be surprised if that happens. Yeah, I don't know why he's afraid of it. He's fine with everything else. He actually, he likes the Triceratops. When he was a kitten, he used to actually crawl underneath the Triceratops' head and sleep there. Okay. Okay. You think it's like a multiple snake monster? Could be. I want to go to the workshop first. Wait, how do I change what my cat looks like again? I can't remember. Is it like here? No. Like, how do I can't remember how to change my cat. Do I have to do it at my house? There we go. This is actually so much stronger, though. So, I think we'll have to wait till we get better equipment, because... Okay. Let's go. Alright. I'm gonna go to the canteen. Can you believe it? It's finally happening. We chased it across sea, got our ship wrecked by it, hunted all over the New World looking for it. And now our strange relationship with Zora Magdaros is about to reach a new plateau. We're gonna capture it!
Oh, yeah!
My grandfather boarded that ship and came here with the first. He said he was ready to complete his mission here in the New World, or die trying. Do you think old Magma Brains even understands why it's here, or is it just compelled? On this run from assassins, eh? Okay. So, should I do bow or bug stick for this one? I have no idea, to be honest. It's the one where they were talking about it last time, where we, like, there's, like, two walls, and we're gonna try and trap the big dragon thingy. So singing, maybe, like, the stick?
Okay.
Maybe I'll even just use the stick for most of the main quest, and then we'll just mess around with the bow or something. There's reasons you'd pick both. Well, Mux says stick. You said stick as the first one. Last time we didn't pick Mux's option, so now we'll pick Mux's option. Bow's useful for environment. Stick is better for bosses. Okay. No, that's like a good, that's a good way to think about it. To go. So, like, general quest, use the bow. It's a boss thingy. If we're going after a big guy, use a stick. I can run with that.
This is gonna work.
Chief! Commander!
So?
We'll get it ready by morning, I promise.
I'll hold you to it. When the time comes, you know what to do. The operation will commence at daybreak.
Sounds like we got our work cut out for us, eh, old man?
By next moonrise, Zora will be in chains.
Oh.
Get to your posts now.
Whoa. Think I'm gonna need a bigger bug sticker.
Use the cannons and ballistae. Wear the beast down. If you've been wounded, retreat to the rear camp.
Now, now! Hold nothing back.
Where am I supposed to go? Cannon? Can I, like, make this go quicker? Okay, there we go.
Move.
Proceed with caution.
Move!
Ah!
Ah, don't fall.
It's time to restrain this beast. Ready your binders.
Climb up. The binder is on top of the barrier.
Okay, up
fire
here.
On the ballista when you're ready.
Maybe I do this while it... This actually seems like a decent way to do this. Uh-oh. Hey, Tooch! Yep. Apparently I broke something. I broke it. I'm all out of stuff.
What's the target's condition?
It's still not weak enough to capture, sir.
Thank you.
breaching the first barrier! Zora Magdaros breached the first barrier!
Oh, crap.
Alright, next phase. Zora Magdaros has broken through! Hunters, grab your transports and proceed to the mounting phase of the operation!
Move it, hunters! Get to a hitching post!
Oh!
Got it! Boarding that sucker now!
This is where it really counts, partner! You can do it!
I'm guessing that's the spot up here.
Now, now!
You knocked that bit of the beard off.
Give us some orders!
Find the magma cores on Zora's shell. Those are its weak points, so if you attack them, it'll wear the beast down.
Watch out for that magma! It's spewing out of those cores! That's one of those cores! Attack it!
Ow! I got lava'd. I got lava again. Ow. I'm not very good at this. Tried. Okay.
Magma core destroyed.
There's one.
Zora Magdaros did not like that one bit.
Good. Find the next one.
Wait, can I loot this? Yes, I can. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? Guessing it's down here. No? Maybe this way.
Thank you.
supposed to go? There's some good crafting mats in this area. You found this confusing to navigate? Okay, I'm not the only one.
Has reached the second barrier.
All right, let's restrain this beast. Ready your one-shot binders. Fire!
That's a hit. We've restrained it. Wait, what's that? What is that? That black figure up in the sky.
Oh no. Hunters, you need to get up under Zora Magnaros' shell right now!
A monster! Some unknown monster has appeared on Zora Magnaros' shell.
Ballista team, get ready to provide support. Hunters, get Zora's back now!
Ballista team, acknowledged. On it.
Careful there, partner. That's the mysterious black monster we've been hearing about. The one that left those thorns behind.
Whoops. Kill it.
Aim. Fire.
Yeah. Woo!
Nergy. Oh. Okay. Dude, should you want to see the new friend?
All right, gather around. Let's get council underway.
We have a giant octopus now. Complete with tentacles. And suckers. I know. I love it so much. Comet, on the other hand, not so much. Comet, that's an octopus. He'll get over it. He will. He's like quick to react and sulk, but then he like quickly gets over things.
First, your reports. Where do we stand
so.
Right now?
Since it reached the Great Ravine, we've lost track of it, sir. The situation has made it quite difficult for us.
That thing is fucking huge. How do you lose it?
However, I think we have a chance to salvage the situation if we can pick up its trail on the other side.
It's a fucking walking mountain!
Got some good news from the field team on that front. Tectonic movement from when Zora passed through created a fissure in the Great Ravine. That fissure is our ticket to catching up with the beast.
Hi.
There's no point. We exhausted our supplies during the last operation. Even if we did track it down, there's no way we'd be able to pull off anything of that scale.
So, Tachio, how's the PS5 treating you?
We'll have to send a ship to the guild.
A ship?
But with the skies and seas the way they are.
It doesn't matter. We cannot proceed without notifying the guild of the situation. We should send word and wait for their decision. Captain, can I count on you?
Never you worry, sir. I've been watching the sea churn and waiting for my chance to tame her again.
You just discovered it was turning itself on with the TV, so you turned that setting off. Yeah, I saw that. I turned that off just because... I don't even know if it would work for me, just because everything goes through, like, switches and capture cards and all sorts of shit. You also realize you can remote play it from your PC. When I was visiting Mux, I actually remote played Genshin on the PS5 from the PS4, because running it that way, even with the latency... was still faster than running it just on the PS5. Or just on the PS4. Because of the hard drive speed. Like, I don't know if you play Genshin mostly on PC or console, but on the PS4, it took so long to load from, like, if you're fast traveling. But I've been babied by the PS5 where it's, like, instant. So the first time I tried to fast travel on the PS4, I was like, I could have walked here faster. So after that, if I was actually doing anything, I would play, I remote played the PS5. The PC is fast. Well, that's like my streaming PC is like two NVMEs. I don't have anything like that in the gaming PC just yet. I've got, I think, what is it? Like one 500 gig or 400 gig solid state for gaming? And then the rest is just hard drives. And then, like, a tiny ass solid state for Windows.
Together, we're going to brave whatever lies on the other side and find Zora Magdaros's.
But yeah, Tichio, the PS5 is fast. Tichio, you gotta get something like Returnal, what else have we played that was actually PS5 that actually really made use of the controller? Returnal, Falconeer did it. I can't remember if Guardians did it or not. I don't think Dark Souls didn't really. I'm just gonna have to make use of the adaptive triggers. The adaptive triggers are like freaking awesome. What else have I played on the PS5? Returnal is on there. As a thing to try. Did you see my playthrough, Chichi? I still have to play more because I haven't technically beaten the game apparently. Demon Souls does? It uses the adaptive triggers? What else have I played on the PS5? Why can't I think of what else I've played on the PS5? Hang on, this is gonna bug me now. Let me check my playlist. No, not that. Did Kena do it? I don't know if Kena did it. Although I would still recommend Kena. But I don't know if they really use the adaptive triggers. I think Returnal's the big one I'm thinking of to use, like, fully use the adaptive triggers. Because it uses them for, like, to give you essentially a whole extra button. So I think that's the one I'm thinking of. Because, yeah, I'm looking through my YouTube playlist just to kind of get a feel for the games I've done. And that's the only one that really kind of makes sense, I think. Yeah, I did play some Astro's Playroom. It's very interesting in what the controller can do. Oh, yeah, you were impressed. I freaking love this baby. Gran Turismo 7 might. I don't mind racing games, but I'm kind of more, I like more like the Burnout style, where it's like, the point is to crash. My brother-in-law, though, is like super into the racing games.
Hunters, head to the Great Ravine as soon as you're ready.
If you can pick up Falconeer, like, cheap, I don't know, I need to play it more, the little bit I did play seemed like kind of slow. But that one, it has full recoil on the triggers. Falconeer, what really got me with that game is that they actually give you recoil on the triggers. So when you pull, it shoots back. Forbidden West will... Oh, I will be disappointed if Forbidden West doesn't fully use the controller. I'm super excited for that. So, obviously, pull's still open, but right now I'm leaning towards dumping the difficulty and trying to blow through it in, like, the first couple of hours on Saturday. For Pathfinder, just so that we can start the story replay of Zero Dawn, so we can get that in before Forbidden West. Zero Dawn is like legit one of my favorite games of all time, I think, still. Just because I found the story incredible. Especially from like an ecology, like having an interest in ecology and evolution. And the whole fact that like I could totally see us destroying our world by accidentally making all life-devouring, self-reproducing robots. Like, I think in the Forbidden West, it happened in, like, 40 years. Like, 40 years from what is actually, like, literally right now or something like that. I don't think it would happen that quick. But, like, maybe, like, 100, 200? I could see it.
Greetings. Hurry back now.
Wildspire waste. No, I've already looked into it, and Forbidden West comes out on a Friday, so I'm probably going to stop and try to pick it up on Friday to try and get the digital or the hard copy. My little piggy. Wait, what's this? Nerdigante's arrival. Subsequent disappearance always coincided with a certain event.
I wonder.
Okay.
New products in stock.
I want to go check out my upgrades and shit.
I've got new stock in.
I have a lot of money. Holy crap. Oh. Can it use the adaptive trigger as an haptic? I thought it did.
How's your gear holding up?
Screw it, let's just go kill shit. I kind of want to try, let's try the bow a bit. Double check and see if I can upgrade this. I mean, I can make that if I had. Maybe I'll just stick with my stick for now. I don't know. I can't decide. I'm feeling very indecisive right now, guys. Let's just go do a quest.
Great, we made it. Let's start by finding a way forward.
And how are things, Mux? Still looking smooth enough for you?
I think we can get through if we head this way.
It's been really nice. Good.
Zora Madros went straight through. We didn't even slow it down. I'm guessing there's something pretty important on the other side. Look at this massive fissure it made. This is the power of an Elder Dragon.
Thank you.
We gotta be careful not to fall here.
She says as I, like, sprint through.
Think we're getting close?
Pretty. Mushroom land? Coral. Either way, it's pretty.
Down there.
First, like, the silhouette, when you saw it, like, flying below, reminded me of the, I can't remember what they're called, but from, Avatar. The flying thingies that they ride. I want to watch that movie again. I haven't seen it in a while.
You awake? I don't know where we are.
Oh, hello. You're awake. Do you remember your fall? A friend of ours found you napping in the Vale and carried you here, but more to the point... Congratulations, you found the Third Fleet. I'm their leader, to the extent that still means something. And this is our research base. Our fleet consists entirely of scholars.
Hmm.
Which fleet are you with? And how did you get here? What happened in the Great Ravine?
Hmm.
Oh. The latest Elder Dragon to make the crossing, and it breached the Great Ravine where you tried to capture it?
Hmm.
I finally get to do what we came here for. I must say that I'm stimulated. What? What? Do you want something? Come here. Come here. Hi. What do you want? Sleep time for you? No worries. I mean, I probably won't go too much longer to chill. I'm really tired. I want to stab something. So. I'll probably stab a few things and then go to bed myself. So. You have a good night, Tachiel. An expedition into the Coral Highlands might be fruitful, wouldn't you agree? Nice thorough expedition should reveal the Highland secrets.
Doing a careful expedition into the Coral Highlands sounds like a good idea to me.
Hey there.
Do you mind taking this as a charm? It's a subject of all my research. I believe it may improve one of your equipment skills, or even give you a new one. Go on, give it a try. I've been waiting for ages for a hunter to come along to try it out in the field. Oh. Charms are pieces of gear that can activate skills. Only one can be equipped at a time. Charms can be created by selecting forge equipment at the smithy. Okay. Can I see? Okay. Well, that actually looks like a good idea.
Nothing can stop us.
What does this camp do? Camp offers 5 basic amenities. Use them to prepare for the hunt. Okay.
You can change your weapons and armor here. Make sure you're always prepped and ready for what comes next.
Okay! So I can actually move shit out of here. Oh my god! This makes things so much easier. I just discovered this is a thing, by the way. Because I want room for the new shit we're gonna find, right? Makes sense? There we go. Okay. Whoa, sky jellies. And this sky makes it look like we're underwater. This is cool. Am I just supposed to jump off? This is your favorite zone until Iceborne? I still don't even know if I have access to Iceborne. I'm just gonna have to wait and see when we get there, I think. Okay, I'm guessing I have to go down this way now. This place is hella cool. You wouldn't, it's base game as part of the PlayStation Plus group. I'm just confused because in my library it says Monster Hunter World Iceborne. Like, it's really confusing. I don't think I do because it also asks me to go buy it, but... That's cool. Well, no, I'm not gonna be upset either way because I've been wanting to try this game. It's just hard to sometimes justify buying a game, especially one that's gonna end up being kind of you know, potentially eat a lot of time, which I don't necessarily have. So. Can I kill this thing? I can. So, like, at the very least, it's a good chance for me to try the game, and then if I like it, I can always buy it, buy the expansion, whatever. Why does it make a horse noise? Ghost snowman. Flasher. Go, go, go. Ow. Yeah, these things make pony noises. Go away. Oh, don't go away. Oh my god, this is a lot of pony cats. proof. There we go. You almost have to hit him from on top. Am I even supposed to be trying to fight this thing yet? Oh, it's like flatlining. Oh, that's probably why I'm doing shit damage. Is that why my weapon keeps bouncing off of him? Yes, it is. Okay. Well. I found another monster. This thing looks kind of like a mouse dragon. Okay, fight each other while I sharpen my weapon. Mouse dragon, you will have to wait. Like Palumu esque cute armor, they must be slaughtered. Get him! Ah! Back here. He keeps running away. You keep hearing a chicken? Keep him occupied, penguin! I think I broke his pretty head thingy. Hey, sorry, dude. You shouldn't be so mean. No, I didn't break it! Not entirely, anyways. Sharpen it first. Wait, he just went down and then he went back up. Oh, it's because this is a nest, I think. So he tries to get away, but then he ends up coming back here to try and rest, to heal, would be my guess.
Hmm.
I got him! They'll keep trying to go to their nest early on. It was funny because it would fall asleep with the player in fairly close proximity. I mean, this one kept trying to, but then I shot a bug at it. Why is it still telling me to go up? I looted it already, didn't I? I don't think I can get anything else from here. Okay, let's go. Because we can finish this up and then I can go sleep. That was definitely, I just want to kill things for like 5 minutes, guys, and then I'm going to go to sleep. It turns into like half an hour of me like hunting. And now I'm tired. Something here sings like whales. Okay. We are not going to find something else to hunt. I need to sleep.
Build the camp here. Let's ask the head honchos. Sounds like the research base has a new guest. Want to go back and check in? And maybe grab something to eat?
How do I get back? I'm tired. How do I get back? Well, those things are cool. Oh, is it like over here? Yes. Okay, good. There we go. Success. Take all. Added fortress crab? The fuck is a fortress crab? Guys, sometimes playing games when you're too tired is like a serious mind trip. I feel like I'm not all here right now. And like, I just like looked up and saw this thing and my mind was blown. I need to sleep, I think. Like, oh my god.
Yo.
Hurry for octopuses. Sleep would be good if I'm feeling that. Yeah! I mean, usually not a bad idea. Ugh. Resurrect the wrecked base? As in rigging it with balloons to reconvert it into an airship. And the leader's here. Here is all for it.
Oops.
Want to get going?
Okay. All right, guys.
Balloons, the sky, all of this is amazing.
Oh, gliders. Alright guys, I'm gonna head to bed. I hope you guys all have a great night. We'll see you guys all tomorrow. Until then, bye everybody.